Hey everyone, Jack Justice. Okay, we're gonna. There might be some editing needed. I'm
talking
sorry.
About video, yeah. I mean, a 10-minute video, right. Hour okay. long to take. Yeah.
Okay, first intro of the day. All right. Hey everyone, Jack Justice here, CEO at Ramblin' Jackson and TNLA Academics Instructor. Right now, I'm at the 2021 Nursery Landscape Expo in San Antonio, Texas. And today we're talking with Patrick Anderson from Rainbow Tree Care Scientific Advancements. Patrick, what is Rainbow Tree Care Scientific Advancements?
Sure. So what we do is we produce plant healthcare products and equipment for the green industry, specifically for landscape arborists and then landscape maintenance companies. And real quick, too, it's really interesting. We actually started back in the 70s. Our founder, his whole business model was injecting elm trees preventatively for Dutch elm disease. So we grew from that into a full kind of product development company.
Well, and, you know, so right now we're recording a video, and I wanted to talk to you about video, because video is just so powerful, especially in the green industry. You know, there's a shortage of labor that everyone's feeling, and one of the things that you can do is make video. And the cool thing about video, I've literally personally made thousands of videos, and what you make one of them one time, and it can be watched hundreds and even thousands of times. And so I wanted to hear, what was last year like with COVID and shutdowns, and how did you lead your team to use video during that time?
Yeah, no, great question. So that is kind of our competitive advantage in the market against other companies similar to ours, is this kind of promise to get out and work in the field with the clients. So making sure they're using the equipment correctly, using the product for the right pest, right disease, things like that. And so when COVID happened, and obviously we weren't getting out anymore, it kind of was like a grinding halt, like, all right, so how do we continue to do what we've always done without physically being there? And that's where we really pivoted within a week or so afterwards to creating both videos that would be able to rewatch, and then also creating, in a sense, like an outdoor studio. So we could do, you know, in the past, someone might call and say, can you be here tomorrow? That wasn't happening last year. So we created this kind of like outdoor studio so that we could live stream not only you know, the video, but live stream, record the video, and then reuse that, edit it, and reuse it for other clients that would then, you know, again, call in and ask for the support and help, because, you know, the industry didn't shut down. You know, in most states, people were still getting out and doing applications. So we still needed to be there to help them.
Yeah, you know, so yeah, during COVID, much of the green industry was deemed essential. They were still doing work, and then people started spending more time at home than ever before, and they started noticing, hey, I think my tree might be sick, or I think I might redo my lawn. And people, you know, have in the green industry have been used to meeting in person. That's something that stopped for a lot of people. They didn't want to meet. And I really believe video can make up for some of that, you know, rapport building when people can see and hear you. And we actually, I work with somebody in Ennis, Texas, who makes video on social media. And he found that he felt a real leverage as a business owner, because his customers would come and say, hey, oh, I saw your video. And they felt like they were seeing him, even though they hadn't seen him in a while. So talk to us a little bit, how do you get non-video people to make video? How do you get tree care chemical applicators, tree care specialists? How do you get, I mean, these people are out in the field. Was there any resistance from them to making video?
There was. So, and again, there's a broad spectrum, right? But certainly, yeah, it was a challenge at first. And I think that, and especially internally, when we said, all right, this is what our plan's going to be, there were a lot of people that were like, oh, how are we going to make this happen? How are we going to make this work? But it came down to the fact that, you know, we really had no other options. And so there was definitely an enrollment period. But once we got that first one done and that second one done, it just started kind of, you know, snowballing from there to the point now where it's going to change the way we do and train things into the future. You know, namely with some of these things that would be, you know, easier to train, maybe something that would only take, you know, 5 or 10 minutes in the field to do, we can send a video now. Even if it's going to be a protocol that's more intensive, we can send that video prior and they can be completely prepared for it. So it makes us now even more dynamic in what we can offer, how we can offer. And just as you know, in our industry, a lot of people are hands-on. A lot of people need, you know, we'd like to do things over and over again, repeat training. So being able to kind of go back to those videos over and over again, and now a technician can watch it on his phone you know, just before going out and doing an application again. So it makes it really, really efficient for us.
And so what did you use? Did you buy video gear? Did you have people use their own smartphone? Or how did you actually make these videos?
The first video was my Samsung tablet on a tripod about that tall that was perched on my trash can. and that's where we started from, because we needed to start again. We had, you know, trainings booked in the county. We get booked out, you know, months ahead of time. So we had trainings that were booked that we needed to kind of, you know, move on for folks. So that's how it started. By mid-year, we had HD cameras. We had, you know, ring lights. We had tripods. So we went from really, really basic stuff to getting a little high tech, you know, as we went on. And, you know, again, learning curve there as well. But even to this day, we started another process where we started doing just neat little diagnostic videos throughout the year. And I still just record those on my cell phone and send them out.
Yeah, for sure. So right now, I mean, we have a camera crew. We're using a lot of expensive equipment. But you don't have to get started that way. In fact, with my own videos, I made for over 5 years, most of them on my iPhone. And you can get attachments, you can get microphones, tripods, lighting accessories, and I think making a good enough video should be the goal, and you just start making them, and over time you get better at them, and your standard for good enough gets better, and then your quality goes up. But you know, we have another client in Frisco who is using video on their iPhone, and one of the things that they're doing, again, video can be a major time saver. They update the inventory page. They're a nursery garden center, and what do people do? They call in and say, "Hi, do you have? How many purple petunias do you have? Oh, can you hold those till Friday?" No, we can't. No, it's going to change in an hour. So they make a video every day that's like, hey, here's our current inventory. They make it once. They put it on their website, YouTube, Facebook, send it out. And then their outgoing voicemail, they tell people to go watch the video at their website inventory page. So
same experience on time saving thing, you know, where we would need to create a document and, you know, have it reviewed and then, you know, sent out to everybody. Same thing, you know, if it's a simple communication for a client, we can just create the video, put it on our YouTube page. Diagnostics is a thing. We do a lot of diagnostic support. So, and, you know, if you've ever done diagnostics before, you know, you'll get like a picture of a brown leaf, right? And like, what's wrong with this? Well, so we can create a video now to explain exactly, you know, if you want us to help you with diagnosis, what we need, you know, versus writing, you know, a page document. Now you just have a simple video showing, you know, this is a good sample, this is a bad sample, real, almost hands-on, virtually hands-on almost, and it makes it a ton easier.
Well, and so what would, what's been the impact of this on the business, you know, because How has it helped you? Has it saved time? Has it made things more efficient? What are some of the benefits of doing all this video work?
So, time for sure. So again, kind of going back to something I mentioned earlier on, you know, because our promise to our clients is to get out there and work with them hands on the field, make sure they really understand what they're doing. Some of these protocols are really simple. You know, within 10 minutes, you got it. So if I need to travel 4 hours for a 10-minute meeting, you know, that's 4 hours. That's a lot of downtime. But if I can send them a video that gets the point across, follow up, make sure that they're comfortable with that, then that's 4 hours back on our day. And then, of course, you know, all that kind of snowballs backwards, right? So it's, you know, that's gas, that's lunch for the day. Mm-hmm. You know, now I'm in my office, or our other tech staff are in their offices, being more productive, get more things done. It's been, you know, from that standpoint, it has been a huge time saver, a way to conserve money. And, you know, again, we're a very hands-on industry. Now that things are opened back up again, we've been back out there, we're going to continue to do what we've always done, but there's going to be this kind of subsection of, you know, clients or, you know, protocol training things that we're going to be able to augment or supplement with the videos that we're going to just, again, find more time to do other things with. So
great. Well, Patrick, thanks so much for doing the interview. Where can people see your videos and learn more and connect with you?
Sure. Great. So you can go to our website. It's treecarescience.com. You can find us on YouTube, which is also just go on YouTube and type in tree care science. And then we're active also on LinkedIn. So that's where we like to send out a lot of our, you know, maybe a weekly diagnostic video of what we're finding throughout the country.
Wow, I love it. Well, thanks so much for interviewing today. And everyone, check out treecarescience.com. What an awesome website. Can't believe you got that domain name.
Way back in the 90s.
All right. Thanks so much.
Thank you.